We're back with AM Live on TSPN, and we're here with Millie Butler from Amador Arts. Good morning, Millie.
Good morning.
Good to have you.
Thank you.
I remember last year you were here, and I was just thinking how quickly a year goes by. It's already that time of the year for the Amador Arts, for the Art by the Inch, and it just seemed like it was just yesterday.
I'm excited to talk about it.
Yeah.
I first want to talk about the concept of Art by the Inch.
Mm-hmm.
We got the idea from Marin County,
mm-hmm.
and basically it's a collaborative mural project where several artists work on a large mural that's 7.5 feet long by about 4 feet tall.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Is there a theme to it?
Each artist group come mm-hmm. up with a different theme for their mural,
mm-hmm.
and I'll show you how it works.
Yeah.
These are mats that we have pre-cut,
mm-hmm.
and what happens is people will come to the event. We're going to have the murals standing on large panels so you can step back and see the whole mural.
Yeah.
And they'll take a mat and compose their own picture.
Yeah, whatever picture within a picture.
Yeah, yeah. So they get to decide what mm-hmm. it is they want to see in their picture, and they can make it go any different way.
Or you can even do... Yeah,
you
this
can
is,
do
any shape.
This is all in the concept with an overall theme, though, or not?
Well, each mural might have a theme. I'll talk about those
okay.
in a minute. But, for example, this is, this piece is, the opening is 10 by 14, and we would be cutting around the outside edge of it, so it would be a $70 piece.
Oh, so, okay,
and there's
good.
A list of the prices here. So
that's
we're
not bad.
Selling the art for 50 cents a square inch.
Okay. 70 bucks for an original is not
yeah.
bad. That's
so
good.
We try to price it so it's affordable for people.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This is what the paper, it's large paper, and it's very durable. It's really nice to paint on.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a piece that I just sold this morning to Deb Goldsmith.
Oh, great.
From leftover from last year. And you can see that it's JB's.
Yeah, cool.
I would like to talk about the participating artists, especially the professional ones.
Mm-hmm.
We have two main groups of artists working on murals. And the first one is Julie Trail, Judy Day, and Evelyn Laura Lowe,
mm-hmm.
and they're doing Amador County through the seasons.
Beautiful.
And Julie, and both Julie and Judy, I know, show in a lot of different places in the county. So people, their mural sold really well last year, and I know people are excited to see what they're doing in this year.
Yeah, that is exciting. Yeah, exactly.
And then the other group of professional artists is headed by Laura Lee Rose, who is actually not a painter, but she's a sculptor, and she does beautiful work with feathers, and she makes human figures and masks and all kinds of wonderful things.
That's so cool.
But she's hosting two murals at her studio,
mm-hmm.
and Bruce Pichani, Annie Hughes, Sarah Dixon, Leslie Vasquez is doing one of the murals that has landscape.
I love Leslie's work.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And the other mural that Laura Lee is hosting is featuring more abstract.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a combination. And then we've got Kim Vinciguerra and Ann Doner are doing a mural with the ARC people.
Oh, yeah. Love that.
So they're excited. They're really excited about participating
mm-hmm.
in that this year. And then the other three murals are all school groups. Rand Huggett's doing some birds with Amador High School, and I'm doing Jackson Holmes with my students at Argonaut High School, and then Pam Sharp, who's she has a children's studio at the Hanford Street Gallery in Sutter Creek. She's doing something with her students too. So we have a pretty wide variety
mm-hmm.
of people participating.
And when is this event?
Well, we're having a preview of all the murals on May 16th at the Arts Networking event. It's
mm-hmm.
going to be over at the Jackson Civic Center from 6 to 8, and people that belong to Amador Arts get in for free. Everybody else is $5, except for the artists that are participating. Of course, they get in for free.
And this will be at the where they have the city council meetings?
Main Civic Center, yes.
Right.
Yeah.
Right next to Jackson City Hall.
Uh-huh.
And so that's a preview.
Of the mural. So we'll have wine. People can buy a glass of wine. Or Megan O'Keefe is going to be playing music.
Mm-hmm.
It's a social event that's fun to, and everybody's excited about seeing what the artists have come up with.
So you didn't do that last year?
Yes, we did do it last year in the same place.
And what time does it start?
6 o'clock.
Okay, that should be fun.
Yeah, that's great. And then the actual event is...
The actual event is at Jazzin' It Up in Jackson on June 22nd.
Okay.
And I'd like to talk about that. Do you know about Jazzin' at all?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Okay, so it's three... There are... it's the third year. There are three bands and three stages for the bands. What the event consists of is wine tasting in over 20 of the shops with 20 mm-hmm. over 20 wineries.
Yeah.
And it's a free event. If you want to buy a wine glass to taste, then if you buy it ahead of time, it's $25. At the day of the event, it's $30.
Mm.
But Art by the Inch is going to be featured out in the middle of the street. We're going to be closing the street this year, so it'll be a little bit safer. Mm-hmm. And Art by the Inch will get a lot more exposure because it's going to be out in the middle of the road.
Yeah, that's
great. We also have a raffle for Tahoe that's going to take place at Jazzin' Up in Jackson.
You know what? We're actually at the end of the segment here. So, are you going to stick around to the end? Because you can wrap it up at the very end.
Sure.
Good. That'd be great.
Okay.
That's great of you.
Yeah. Yeah. It seems like awesome. So much going on. Thank you. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.